Today we're talking about the Abolish ICE movement. Because, well, everyone is. Although it's a New York summer, we're gonna need all the ICE we can get. Now, because politics are the way they are, this issue has already pretty much fell into camp love or hate ICE. Like it's a Survivor contestant that might get voted off the island. Unfortunately, there's probably a little more nuance to all this than an evil or divine agency. So today I want to look at some of the arguments on both sides and, you know, just figure out what's going on. First, what is ICE? Because we might have more border agencies than border agents right now. There are a lot. I mean, you have the Immigration and Naturalization Service, the Border Patrol, the Customs Service, the Coast Guard, TSA. Heck, even friend of the show Ryan Zinke and his Department of the Interior have their own border influence.
Interior owns about 40% of that, and we're looking at designs, we're looking at where it's appropriate to make the wall. Some places that are national park down there, the wall is a 100-foot cliff that's all resistance. The tribes are very important to consolidate or consult with a tribe.
Basically, we have so many people watching the border, I'm surprised we haven't yet needed to outsource any of that to undocumented labor. ICE is the principal investigative arm for the Department of Homeland Security. And their mission is to detect and prevent terrorist and criminal acts by targeting the people, money, and materials that support terrorist and criminal networks. And they've been doing a great job at catching all sorts of terrorists, from the 7-Eleven clerks trying to make a living, to workers in meatpacking plants. You know, terrorists. But only for people scared of blue-collar workers trying to get by. One thing I keep hearing is that ICE agents aren't doing their jobs anymore. And in the federal law enforcement equivalent of playing Tetris on your computer, ICE agents are trying to look busy by arresting illegal immigrants until finally that whole terrorism thing really kicks into gear again. The thing that I'm really surprised doesn't come up in the debate ever is, well, that it's just not true. In fact, it's weird how little we talk about ICE's counterterrorism successes. For example, ICE JTTF special agents were influential in identifying the would-be Times Square bomber. Now, I've written enough resumes to be healthily skeptical of all this. Oh, you were influential in identifying the Times Square bomber? Well, I was influential in dictating US trade policy because I interned at the United States Export Assistance Center for the summer. I know that most New Yorkers, me included, hate Times Square, but that still would have been a tragedy, so tragedy averted. Now that might seem like an isolated incident, but there are tons of examples of counter-terrorist ICE successes that I couldn't find any reporting of. Like, an ICE JTTF special agent led the investigation and conviction of the Brooklyn imam accused of tipping off terrorists days before the attempted attack against the New York City subway system. Wow, I really should move. In fact, the deeper you dig into ICE's achievements, the less it seems like a deportation machine for immigrants, and the more it seems like the resume of a liberal arts kid who really can't figure out what he wants to do. A quick perusal of their Wikipedia page, and the fact that I'm using Wikipedia should tell you how desperately I was grabbing at straws to find out what the heck they actually stood for. Well, that search will show you that they have a really good record of combating child exploitation and combating child pornography. Which, okay, yeah, that's bad, but it kind of feels like you're spreading yourself a little thin. Then you get into reporting leaders who participated in the Rwandan genocide back to Rwanda, fighting arms trafficking, and fighting local gangs, and it's like, seriously, ICE, learn to delegate a little bit. I mean, honestly, I told you what their official role was up top, but it kind of feels like to even begin to describe what ICE currently does, you'd need to include more buzzwords than a management consultant's PowerPoint presentation. We're talking cross-platform synergistic management solutions to better optimize efficiency and facilitate... So, why such a long intro? Well, because you should be angry when you hear nuanced interpretations like...
Before ICE, the US didn't have an agency dedicated to deporting people who pose no threat to us. Until the current wave of wall humpers came to power, a lot of conservatives were totally cool with that.
I believe in the idea of amnesty for those who have put down roots and who have lived here, even though sometime back they may have entered illegally.
That's not to say that parts of that aren't true, and stick with me because we'll get to that as soon as I finish this thought. But to judge a department solely on the parts you don't like while completely ignoring everything else it did would be like me saying we should get rid of Obamacare because all it does is make people who don't have health insurance have to pay a premium. Alright, so ICE and illegal immigrants are about as notoriously bad a fit as, well, ice and fire. And brace yourself because this is where things get ambiguous. Because ICE kind of feels like the Jared Kushner of government agencies. In 2003, immigration responsibilities were broken up from one truly bulky immigration system that had perfected the ability to spend a lot of money while delivering the lowest acceptable results into three separate entities. First, you had legal immigration processing. Well, that's a United States Citizenship and Immigration Services thing. Then you had border enforcement. That's gotta be Customs and Border Protection. And that leaves us with interior enforcement. Clearly, that's a job for Immigration and Customs Enforcement. But with all the jobs interior enforcement entails, it's no surprise that, according to ICE's own website, today ICE is more than 20,000 strong with a presence in all 50 states and 48 foreign countries. You guys deal with interior crimes. Why do you operate in 48 foreign countries? Your interior enforcement. Have you even read your mission statement? At this point, I'm researching ICE. I feel like I could tell you more about the Illuminati's plans. Anyway, back to the issue at hand, because ICE was broken up into three distinct branches: Homeland Security Investigation, the Office of Principal Legal Enforcement, and Enforcement and Removal Operations. Can you guess which one is controversial? It's the one with removal in its name. The problem was that, while immigration was a somewhat incompetent system in the pre-ICE days, ICE is really good at tracking down undocumented immigrants who have done nothing wrong, except either enter the country or be brought into the country illegally.
Under Trump, the Department of Homeland Security has operated under new guidelines that allow ICE to target immigrants who were previously largely safe from deportation because they had done nothing wrong. The Post reports that ICE made 37,734 non-criminal arrests in the government's 2017 fiscal year, more than twice the number in the previous year.
This basically goes back to the DACA argument of whether the government should prioritize felony illegal immigrants over others, or stick to a gotta catch 'em all attitude. This, coupled with the fact that despite immigration enforcement being the most funded part of the US law enforcement by beating out all other agencies combined, I've built pillow forts that look more accommodating than some of our detention centers. And in my pillow forts, there aren't rampant and uninvestigated claims of sexual assault. Although, my No Girls Allowed sign all but guaranteed that would be the case. Furthermore, the Supreme Court has set a 6-month detention deadline before a court case, a deadline that is very often missed. So that's, how do I put this softly? Lacking in constitutionality. All that said, listen to Fox News for a second report Democrat positions.
Our other top story. Far-left cries to abolish ICE are now going mainstream in the Democratic Party, with New York Senator Kirsten Gillibrand becoming the first sitting U.S. senator to publicly call for its elimination.
She's right. It's becoming a major part of the Democratic platform, which is why I can find so many clips of Democrats endorsing it. Oh wait, that's just radical liberals and political comedians. Furthermore, listen to this radical liberal's plan to get rid of ICE.
She's also got some positions that are even to the left of Bernie Sanders. She wants to get rid of ICE.
Well, I agree with it. I don't think ICE today is working as intended.
Well, you think you should get rid of the agency?
I believe that it has become a deportation force. And I think you should separate the criminal justice from the immigration issues.
All right, so the liberal repeal and replace. Most of the calls from people are less to get rid of ICE and more to make ICE do what they were created to do and defend the United States from terrorists and crime rings in the interior of the US, without wasting a ton of time and money chasing down nonviolent illegal immigrants. Now, that's not to say that America would now be a borderless country, because, again, there are a ton of agencies that are in charge of overlooking the border. It's just to say that the part of ICE that has recently evolved to arresting law-abiding, except for the one, citizens. Instead, you're going to have in the interior either getting arrested by the border police or the local police to be deported. Interestingly enough, in a recent letter written to the head of the Department of Homeland Security, ICE officials proposed creating a standalone investigations unit and another agency to handle immigration detention and deportation. This was specifically because, as they said, the Trump administration's crackdown on illegal migrants has limited their ability to pursue national security threats, child pornography, and transnational crime. Man, they really mentioned child pornography more than I was expecting from ICE, but alright. Oh, come on now, anti-terrorists. You're just trying to keep your job. Let's split this company in two. The one part some people want to abolish, and the other part that protects the country from evil. ICE does a lot of things, and some of them are controversial. So, liberals, instead of advocating for abolishing ICE, dare I recommend melting it down, or putting it in the ICE shaver so we can get multiple agencies instead of the one whose job description is all of the above. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello, YouTube. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan comedy news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head. Or do it the old-fashioned way by clicking the subscribe button below. And, of course, remember to give me a thumbs up. And, as always, thank you for watching.